twos and friends. It is my distinct pleasure and great honor to introduce to you Siqi Mou. I'll be honest. I began writing this introduction on October 24th. At the time, a lot of kids were quizzical. They said, George, shouldn't you be at Halloween, having a social life? I said, no. This is Siqi Mou we're talking about, and I got to be focused. It's called work ethic. And let me tell you this right now. If I were to detail, enumerate, explain all of the resume accomplishments that this incredible person has amassed, I would have to petition the dean's office to change this class from a three-unit class to a four-unit class. But the dean's office is very busy this week with something I like to call financial aid gate. If you watch Talk to Him, I told you his name is Adam Alcock. That means he does nothing halfway, I'll tell you that. Now, there is one resume item from Siqi Mou that stood out to me. Because when I was growing up in New York, they used to say to me, young son, do you know what it takes to get to Carnegie Hall? And I never did find out, but we could have just asked Siqi, who is an ambassador to Carnegie Hall. Give it up for that. And what that means is that she goes up to neighborhoods in Harlem where they don't always go to Carnegie Hall. They don't always have the opportunity in some places, and she plays the piano there, and I respect that even more. In fact, you could say that Siqi's story began with her gift of the piano, because she was growing up in China, and she was on a traveling orchestra, and she made it to Stanford to play. She first saw this university, and she wanted to come here, but the odds were against her. It didn't stop her, and she came to Stanford undergrad. And she wanted to get to Wall Street, and the odds were against her, but it didn't stop her, and she got to Morgan Stanley. And she wanted to get to Harvard, and the odds were against her. It didn't stop her, she went to Harvard, and she wanted to get to Stanford. The odds were against her, it didn't stop her, and here she is today on this panel. So you can imagine how excited I was when November 20th came, and that was time for my pre-interview conversation. I didn't even know if she would have time to see me, but I dropped Professor Fern's name and the doors opened up. Yes, I did. Yes, I did. I said, Siqi, how are you so resilient? How do you do it? She said, George, for me, chaos is the new normal. I respect that. And that brings me to why Siqi's here, a startup called HelloAva. That's a startup that she founded, that she fundraises, that she leads, where she sets the tone. And it's a startup about skincare, not just any kind of skincare, skincare informed by artificial intelligence. And that resonated with me because I can't manage my own skincare with my own intelligence. In fact, I took 7 pages of notes, and Candace, those notes were single space. Let me say that. I bring up Candace because Candace and I have the exact same sense of humor, don't we? We sit together in class. Now, Siqi said I could say this, because Siqi and I have a connection, because we both used to have a lot of skin issues. And if you know me, you know I used to be made fun of for being fat. But did you know I also was made fun of for a lack of clear skin complexion? In fact, one time I was in the playground and a kid came up to me and he said, George, what's wrong with your face? You should get some skin cream. And the good Lord came down and said, you're not going to be a match, George. And I told him, I already have 2 skin creams. The first is called personality, and the second is called charisma. If you come down to the George Hayward School of Hard Knocks, we'll give you some discount on tuition. I guess that's a need-based financial aid thing. But Siqi is inspirational. And so I said to Siqi, what was your favorite moment at Stanford? And to go back to the piano, when Siqi got involved here, she signed up for the GSP show. And she didn't know, like many of us, how much time commitment that taste. So she was going to play on the piano, arrange the music, compose some stuff as well. And when it was a week before the GSB show, it was all consuming. Siqi told me that she didn't even know what classes she had. She didn't go to the classes. She doesn't even know how she passed them. But she also said that it was in those moments where people from one community were working together to get something done. That's the memory that stands the test of time. And I think we would do well to remember that. So without further ado, I would like to introduce the unflappable, the unstoppable, the unequivocal, inimitable, Siqi Mou. Thank you.
That would be a biased way of thinking. Thank you, George, for that.